And of course, at the same time in Altoona, a tragic accident has led to an outpouring of support from friends and strangers. Chad Wells of Altoona was killed in a hit-and-run accident yesterday while on his way to work. Angie Hunt explains what's being done to help his family. Angie.
Well, Stacey, as quite often happens, when people hear a story like this, they want to do anything they can to help. A tragic accident.
I just can't imagine losing a band member that way, you know, let alone a family member like that.
A sad reminder.
I don't think it has sunk in yet.
Of just how quickly life can change.
You know, it could happen to anyone. And certainly, you know, our hearts go out to the family and we want to help them as much as we can.
It's the senseless nature of this hit-and-run accident that killed Chad Wells, a husband, father, friend, and musician, that has people wanting to help his family.
When we found out who it was, you know, we were just like, you know, what can we do for this family? You know, our friend, our fellow musician.
So Mark Loomis and other members of the band Deep Fat Fryer decided to dedicate their already scheduled performance Saturday night to Wells and his family.
We're going to dedicate this show to Chad and his family and give any of the proceeds from merchandise sales, anything that the band has paid, it's all going directly to Chad and Angie.
But even people who didn't know Chad or his wife Angie have been touched by what happened.
And this one kind of hit home with me because I live in Altoona, and I take that intersection to go home every night.
And that's why Rick Gady, the general manager of the Renaissance Savory Hotel in downtown Des Moines, is offering complimentary rooms to the family.
I just thought the least we could do is try to help out of state or out of town family that would be coming in for the services.
And a lot of people wanting to help out. If you would like to attend that benefit concert tomorrow night, it does start at 9 o'clock at the Main Gate Bar and Grill in Des Moines. That is just across from the state fairgrounds.
Very nice things people are doing. Angie, any new details in the investigation?
Yeah, I did talk this afternoon with one of the detectives over at the Altoona Police Department. He tells me they were able to recover a GPS system from that stolen vehicle that was involved in the crash. From that, they know that DeJour Sawyers stole that car from Ames around 5:30 Thursday morning. They were able to track his path. He ended up in West Des Moines, eventually in Altoona around that time the accident happened. They know he was in Ames earlier on Thursday evening, Wednesday evening, visiting friends, and that he was going about 86 miles an hour at the time of the crash.
Angie Hunt in our Ames Live link. Thanks, Angie.